Hi, grade 11 student. So in this video, we are going to continue with our inventory system. All right. So in this topic, I pick one of the questions from our study guide. So please, if you want a study guide, guys, now is available for grade 11, but only a soft copy, guys, because to print out a hard copy is taking almost 400 per one guide. So which means that the guide is going to be more expensive. So we decided that it's better for us to sell it as a PDF at the moment until we find the solution to print it out as cheaper as possible so that we can sell it cheaper. So the study guide is only 100 rand. You can text us on WhatsApp so that we can sell it for you. Okay, now on this question paper, we are going to prepare a purchase account. We are going to prepare a sales account as well as trading account. So inventory, guys, is the most simplest topic which we have to get total. Okay, so under part 1 and 2, I already explained what is the meaning of perpetual, what is the meaning of periodic. You can go and check them after this video. Okay, 1.1, use the information provided below to complete the following account in the general ledger for the year end 28 February 2019 and show the entries as follow, as it will have been posted from the relevant subsidiary books. Number 1.1, purchase, sales and trading account. Okay, Zandile Zulu is concerned about the increase of shoplifting when her business has heard that the business that implemented the perpetual inventory system find it easy to detect theft. Explain why it's so important, as well as how they feel the theft can be detected using a perpetual stock system. Okay, let's leave that one for now and do the first one. Okay, purchase account. When you draw purchase account, you only focus on what was purchased by the business in terms of cash and credit. Then the second one, you check what was returned, what was donated, and the withdrawal. This is how you do it. When the stock increase, put it this side. When it decrease or goes outside the business, put it this side. Very simple. Okay. Number one, they give us a trading stock at the beginning and at the end. Opening and closing, you will find it here. Opening and closing. Let's leave it for this part. Let's start by preparing purchase. Okay, carriage on purchase, 22,000 is for this one. Cash purchase for the year, this one. We purchase, is going to increase our purchases. Okay, they say cash purchase is 215,500. Credit purchase is creditors control. Which is 163,600. Okay, and also we have a cash sales, which is this one, and credit sales, which is this one. Cost price of stock taken by the owner for personal use, that's a drawings, is decrease what purchase drawings. It's 18,500. Goods returned to creditors, that's a return. Returns is 10,300. Very simple chapter. Donation of stock to local children home, 8,000 of donation. Okay, now we have to calculate the remaining a purchase that we have so that we can transfer it here. Okay, this side is the higher, which means that we have to calculate this side and get 379,100. 379,100. Take this one and minus the rest, then you will get 342,300. Because we are transferring to trading account, we must name it trading account. Okay, and it's gonna be 342,300. 42,300. Just like that, we are done with this one. Now we're going to prepare this at the same time. Okay, under sales, whatever that we sell, we record this side. When our sales increase, but when our sales decrease like return, we record this side. Okay, let's take a cash sales bank. This is what we receive. Our income is increased by 296,000. And we also have a credit sales, which is debtors control. Control, which amount is 361,400. Okay, and we also have a return, goods returned by a debtor. That is a debtors allowance. Debtors allowance decrease our sales, and it is 7,600. Okay, we are done with this account. We must get total this side, which is going to give us 657,400, and we subtract this, and we're gonna get 649,800. Okay, because we are transferring this one to trading account, we must write the word trading account. 649,800, just like that. Okay, remember we have opening balance and closing balance that we have for trading stock. Copy and paste. Opening, it was 248,900. And closing, it was 236,800. Okay, then carriage and passage, it was given 22,400. Then this side is the one which is higher. We are going to say total is 896,600. 896,600. Then we get profit or loss as a balancing figure by subtracting this to this one, and you will get amount of 273,000. That's how you do it. It's very simple and very straightforward, guys. Those who haven't joined our extra class, make sure that you do that as early as possible, especially for you guys in grade 11. We want to make sure that you understand everything when you are still in grade 11, so that when you join next year, we are going to produce a distinction. So make sure that you communicate with your parents so that they can help you to pay for extra class. I will see you on part. This one is part 3. I will see you on part 4 and the other chapter, which is budget and cost of accounting for term 3.